trust and cling to my blessed King, who by grace now is keeping me. There is grace for every poor each need, grace for you, grace for me, keeping true, keeping free, precious Savior, he's gracing you, flowing from the throne above, grace to cover all my sin, grace to all who believe, oh, this grace I receive, full forgiveness of my way. Yes, there's grace in the Lord's perfect love.
Wonderful grace of Jesus. Aren't you glad this morning for the grace of Jesus? Let's sing that this morning. Wonderful grace of Jesus.
Wonderful grace of Jesus, greater than all my sin. How shall my tongue describe it? Where shall its praise be?
Page number 3.
Wonderful grace of Jesus, reaching the most defiled, by its transforming power, making him God's dear child, purchasing peace and heaven for all eternity. and the wonderful grace of Jesus reaches me. Wonderful the matchless grace of Jesus, deeper than the mighty rolling sea.
Choir sounds so beautiful this morning, and I can't hear you folks at all. All I hear is the choir, and so here we're going to sing a song that we all know. It's one of our favorite songs we sing here. It is Well With My Soul. Seems like we just sang it recently, Brother Dowdy, but that's okay. Page 417, if you need it. I'd like you to lift your voices good and loud this morning. Let's shake the chandeliers with our voices this morning. It is Well With My Soul. You know it. If you need the words, it's page 417. It'll be on the screen. Would you sing it from your heart this morning? Sing it like you mean it. Let's blend like one big choir, all right? You follow Brother Dowdy. We'll do some of it a cappella. You just follow Brother Dowdy, and let's lift our voices together.
Lord, it's the day when the day.
where Brother Dowdy and Miss Dowdy and my family went to, and heard the Collingsworth family sing last night. And they sang the hymn that's in the very front of your hymn book, the Arise, My Soul, Arise. And I've had it on my mind ever since they sang it. I'd like to hear our church sing it this morning. And it'll be the last song we sing this morning, then you can be seated. Don't faint just yet. All right, get a good deep breath and think about the words of this song. We've got some very, very powerful words. Arise, my soul, arise, shake off your guilty fears. The bleeding sacrifice in my behalf appears. Before the throne my surety stands, before the throne my surety stands, my name is written on his hands. You understand the wounds in our Savior's hands, the blood he shed, it was for us. The Father sees his blood when he looks at Adam Summers. He sees me as his child. What an amazing song this is. Let's sing it together. Sing it like you mean it this morning, all right? Good singing. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much for those five bleeding wounds. Lord, thank you for being willing to be our sacrifice. Thank you for pardoning us. Lord, this morning we need your help. I pray that you'd please, God, would you meet the needs of the folks today? Lord, you know our hearts. You know what we need. Father, I pray that you would convict us and encourage us and exhort us. And God, I pray above all that you would be pleased and that you would be glorified through everything that takes place today. We'll thank you for it. We ask it in the name of Jesus. Amen. You may be seated.
Flickering candlelight, Paul's mind began to wonder. could not understand. And he wrote, by his grace, I am what I am. I'm saved and I'm forgiven. I'm redeemed by the Lamb. I am justified before the Most High. No longer an enemy. By the blood I am made nigh. And it's only by His grace that I am. Many times I start thinking about my sin and defeat. Through the lens of constant failures, my frailty I can see. I am just another broken life. Sorrow is all I bring. Oh, wretched man that I am, in me dwells no good thing. But by His grace, I am what I am. I'm saved and I'm forgiven. I'm redeemed by the Lamb. I am justified before the Most High. No longer an enemy. By the blood I am made nigh. And it's only by His grace that I am. How can I come before the Lord with all my guilt and shame? How can I be forgiven and washed from sin's dark stain? By His grace, I am what I am. I'm saved and I'm forgiven. I'm redeemed by the Lamb. I am justified before the Most High. No longer an enemy. By the blood I am made nigh. And it's only by His grace that I am. And it's only by His grace that I am.
stand and sing page number 63, Glory to His Name. And on the second verse, turn around and greet someone this morning. Page number 63.
You may be seated this morning as the aisles are clearing. I have a few announcements we need to make. I think maybe one of the most urgent and important requests this morning, is the sign-up sheet that is in the foyer for the fair booth. The Chelsea Fair does not start this week, but it starts next week. And we really need to fill that sign-up sheet up. And many of you have said you want to get involved, you want to do more around the church. Well, this is your opportunity. And Brother Wireman, how long are the time slots? The 3 hour? Two and a half or 3 hour time slots throughout the day and into the evening. And we just need a few people to man our church booth at the fair, to give out the popcorn and to just greet people as they come by, give out information about the church. And it's very, very easy. And I mean it, anybody can do it. And so we need help signing up. If you, I'll try to announce it at the end of the service, maybe you'll remember as well, but it's out there on the welcome desk, and we need all the help that we can get. So please sign up if at all possible. Ushers, come on with those offering plates. We'll go ahead and get our offering. Now, for those of you that have not heard, Ms. Nancy Zering went home to be with the Lord this week, and the service for Ms. Nancy will be this coming Wednesday. And so please be here if you can. I see Miss Linda and Alana over here. That's Linda's mom, of course, Alana's grandmother. And as you get by and hug their neck, let them know that you're praying for them. The service will be here at the church Wednesday. There'll be visitation at 11, and then the service will be at noon, and there will be a lunch after the service. And I'd like just as many Faith Baptist people come as possible. Let's really come show our support and a concern for Linda and Alana and the rest of the family. Because we're having the meal after the service, I've been asked to announce that we'd like to have some desserts brought. And so if you're able to bring a dessert for that, we'd greatly appreciate it. And if we could know how many we have coming, that would also be a help. So if you can bring a dessert, maybe two desserts, we need to have them here Wednesday morning. And if you're able to do that, would you raise your hand so I can see how many desserts we have? Miss Kimberly's putting together the meal for us. If you can bring a dessert, raise your hand and keep it up until I get done counting. Okay, don't put them back down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 15-ish. All right, and if over here, 16, thank you. All right, so if you can have those here Wednesday morning, that would be a help. And let's just really, let's just love on the family a little bit and encourage them be here. Your presence here will mean a lot to them as well. So if at all possible, please be here for that, if you can, please. And then next Sunday morning, next Sunday evening, we'll be observing communion in the evening service. So please come with your heart prepared accordingly for that. And it seems like communion services are some of the sweetest services when we just spend the entire service reflecting on our Savior. And so we'll be doing that together next Sunday evening. And then in the bulletin it says there is a prayer brunch this month. That is incorrect. There is no ladies' prayer brunch. It was supposed to be taken out and it got overlooked somehow. And so there is no prayer brunch this month because of all that we have going on. And then I have this announcement. This will come as a shock and kind of a sad news for many of you. October is usually our fall fellowship month. That's when we have our 3 days of fall fellowship. We invite preachers from all over to come and be a part of that. And for the last several years, it's become more and more difficult to attract the crowd of out-of-town preachers. And last year especially was a struggle. We had far more local preachers come for the fall fellowship meeting than we had out-of-town preachers. And that's for lots of reasons, and we have all these different theories and reasons for why, but really what it comes down to is we have the fall fellowship is supposed to be to minister to these other pastors and missionaries and those folks that come in, but to be a blessing to them and to kind of just spoil them a little bit. But if they're not coming, then it defeats the purpose. And so we're going to be not having our fall fellowship this year. We're going to skip this year, and next fall we'll kind of reconsider it and revisit the idea and see what kind of response we get. We mail out lots of letters for this. We do. It's two cycles of letters we mail out to all of the churches in our immediate area, but also I have a long mailing list of folks from out of town that have come in years past. And so far this year I've received one response from those letters. One response. And so, yes, it's always a fun week. We always enjoy the fellowship getting together, but I don't think you'd enjoy it nearly as much if you just got up and listened to me preach 15 times during those 3 days. And Brother Wyman says that's right. But anyway, well, I don't know what we're going to do in October. We have a couple of different options. We may try a couple of different things and to replace that fellowship meeting with a different kind of service potentially. But I wanted everybody to know this morning that we're not going to be having the fall fellowship as we normally do. If you have questions about it, feel free to ask me. And if we have more time, I can talk about it. Just not right now. We're out of time this morning. Okay? All right. Brother John Alves is with us this morning. He'll be preaching for us this morning and this evening. And his family is staying in the Prophet's Chamber downstairs. And I'm excited to get to spend some time with them this week. And so we'll be hearing from him in just a couple of minutes. Brother Henniger, you've got the microphone this morning. Would you ask the blessing on the offering?
Heavenly Father, we thank you for this another day, Lord, to come and sing praises to you, Lord, and give for all the grace and mercy you've given us in our lives, Father. We ask that you be with those who couldn't be here today because of sickness, Lord. Watch over them and bring them back to us as soon as possible, Lord. Comfort those that mourn, Lord, and lift their hearts up, knowing that the ones they've lost, Lord, are with you and enjoying your presence. We ask, Lord, to be with Brother Alves, Lord, today as he preaches. Give him your word for us, we pray, and all that he does. Bless him and all he does. And bless this offering, we pray, in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you, Becca. Thank you, musicians, for your help this morning. We're all finished up here. We have one of our missionaries. This is Brother John Alves. Brother John, I was thinking about this morning. You came the first time in 2008. I think you were the first missionary that we took on after I became pastor. I think you were the first missionary that I ever had presented to the church to take on for support in 2008. And man, what a blessing you and your family have been to us over these last 16 years. And the children are growing up back there. And every time we see them, they get bigger and bigger, which I know is just the way things go. But the brother Alves is from Brazil. He is a Brazilian national. He's with Rock of Ages Prison Ministry. He preaches in the prisons in Brazil, which is very easy. It's very safe, very happy, and easy ministry. He is involved in so many different things, and we are so honored to have him back with us another time. And so I want you to open your Bibles and open your minds, open your hearts, and let's let the Lord use Brother John to speak to us this morning. This evening, I've asked Brother John to present his ministry. There's some folks who are not as familiar with him as others. So he's got a short video he'll play and talk a little bit about his ministry, but he'll also be preaching for us tonight as well. All right, Brother John, you make yourself right at home this morning. We love you.
Preciosa graça que salvou paria como eu, perdido estive, salvo estou. Agora filho teu, por entre riscos, lutas mil, cheguei enfim ao lar. Graça trouxe grande alegria aí para estar. Praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God. Praise God, praise God. Praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God. Praise God, praise God, praise God. Brethren, I'm looking for the time. All of us will be together in heaven, amen, worshiping the Lord forever and forever. Amen. One language, all nations, just worshiping, amen, the one that saved our souls. Amen. I sang this song with great gratitude in my heart, because through American churches, I got saved there in Brazil. I praise the Lord for the churches in America to send missionaries around the world. I got saved under the ministry there in Brazil of Brother Jimmy Rose, friend of the pastor, founder of the pastor here before Pastor Adam, Pastor Jack Story. I remember when he was here back in 2008, and he told me our church supported Brother Jimmy Rose in Brazil when he was a young man. And I'm very glad to meet you. Through his ministry, I got saved. So I consider a part of this church. You know, I'm a fruit of this church. I'm a result of a missionary vision of this church. So I really praise the Lord for this church. It's an honor for me and my family to be here. Also, I praise the Lord for this church to send missionaries around the world, and also to support our ministry there in Brazil during the years. Thank you so much. We don't take that for granted, Pastor. Thank you. We love you. We love your family. We love this church. You mean a lot for us. Our kids, they love this church all the time. They talk about if there is a church that I would like to be a member, is I hope I don't, I'm not, you know, I will not neglect other churches, you know, but you know what I'm about to say. But we really love you all. Thank you so much for all you do for us there in Brazil, and also to help us to get here. We have been here in America for a couple weeks, I believe almost 2 months. We went to the Rock of Ages National Conference there in Tennessee. We attend the ministry there. We were in several meetings. But also, I was preaching in some churches and tried to raise a little bit of support to extend the ministry there in Brazil. By God's grace, we are growing. We just accepted 2 new missionaries to work in the prisons there in Brazil recently. And also, we are developing the ministry also in another state. Right now, we are in 3 states in our country, and we are developing the ministry now in the north state of the state we are working now. We have about 20 volunteers, and we are in a partnership with another pastor. So he's an American missionary. And by the way, we will be having a big conference in that area in next month. When we go back to Brazil, several missionaries from Rock of Ages, the vice president and others will be coming down, and we'll have a conference there also. So pray for us for all this project. I will talk more later tonight. I will show you the video, what the Lord is doing there in Brazil, and you have part in that ministry as well. Not only went to national conference and churches here in America, but I was able also to visit some prisons there in Atlanta. I was able to share the gospel with the inmates there in the one very bad prison there in Atlanta, what I heard. And I was able also to communicate with a deaf person. I believe I wrote in my letter. I have a deaf minister there in my church. When I am not preaching outside in my home church, I am an interpreter for the deaf people. And I teach in the Sunday school class to them, and I preach to them. But when I got here in America, of course, the sign language is different than our sign language in Brazil. But I was preaching in a church here in America, and I learned few sign in English also. And one of that was love, like that, like a hug. And I found out when I was in the prison there that one inmate was deaf. And when he found out that I knew the sign language, just make a short story, I went to talk to him, and he was very excited. And one sign language is universal for every country, and it's this, Jesus. So I was able to tell him, Jesus loves you. And he was very, very excited. You know, he was very excited for me to be able to communicate with him. So that's something that was going on that we would like just to give you an update on that. But you pray for me about, I want to preach a message this morning. The theme I was sharing with the pastor, very challenging to me because it's a new message. Never preached before. The pastor was a little apprehensive. I told him, don't be apprehensive. If you want to turn off the YouTube, I just joked on him. But anyway, but the Lord spoke to my heart and blessed my heart. I hope I pray that I will be very clear and to bless the Lord might use the message to bless you. But I want to preach a message entitled The Beauty of His Glory. The Beauty of His Glory. Open your Bible in Exodus chapter 33, verse 11 through 23. You're going to read if you can. Open your Bible. Book of Exodus chapter 33, verse 11. Exodus chapter 33, verse 11. the beauty of his glory. And the Lord spake unto Moses face to face, as a man speaketh unto his friend. What a verse, what a statement that we read right here, brethren. And the Lord spake unto Moses face to face, as a man speaketh unto his friend. And he turned again into the camp, but his servant Joshua, the son of Nun, a young man, departed not out of the tabernacle. And Moses said unto the Lord, see, thou sayest unto me, bring up this people, and thou hast not let me know whom thou wilt send with me. Yet thou hast said, and know thee by name, and thou hast also found grace in my sight. Now therefore, I pray thee, if I have found grace in thy sight, show me now the way, that I may know thee, that I may find grace in thy sight, and consider that this nation is thy people. And he said, my presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest. And he said unto him, if thy presence go not with me, carry us not upon hence. For when shall it be known here that I, then thy people, have found grace in thy sight? Is it not in that thou goest with us? So shall we be separated, and I thy people, from all the people that are upon the face of the earth. And the Lord said unto Moses, I will do these things also, that thou hast spoken, for thou hast found grace in my sight, and I know thee by name. We'll read on verse 18. And he said, I beseech thee, show me thy glory. And he said, I beseech thee, show me thy glory. Let's pray. Lord, I need your grace and your favor as I preach thy word. I need your help, the help of the Holy Spirit in this morning. Give me a clear mind, a clear thought, and may the Lord Jesus Christ be glorified in this morning. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. We just read a very interesting passage of the scripture. Moses is one of the greatest prophets in the Old Testament for me. He is one of the prophets that really lived very close to the Lord. He was all the time earnestly to have a close relationship with God. Moses' relationship with God was amazing. He was chosen by God, he was qualified by God, and he was graced by God also. Moses' prayer request was a unique prayer request. Unusual prayer request. And he said, I beseech thee, show me thy glory. It was not common, this type of prayer request. And Moses, he asked the Lord to show his glory. And that's the theme of the message in this morning, the beauty of his glory. I believe this is a very difficult theme to be shared because of the profound and the deep our Lord it is. God is deep in this morning. He is very difficult to comprehend, to understand, and to describe his glory, it is difficult as well. So, we see here that Moses, he made this prayer request. I beseech you, show me thy glory. So the beauty of God's glory, we can see a glimpse of God's glory. Not really what Moses was praying right now, but we can see a little glimpse of his glory. For example, the Bible tells us in Psalms chapter 19, verse 1, the heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament sheweth his handwork. This is something a little different that Moses was praying, because Moses, God knew his prayer request in the deepest of his heart. This verse is telling us about the glimpse about his glory. The heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament sheweth his hand work. We see the glimpse of God's glory in the creation. Romans chapter 1, verse 20 also tells a little bit about that. I was studying here. For the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse. So we see here also the creation showing us a little bit about his glory. The sun is something, is one of the creation of God that I stay amazed to see. The sun, sometimes he's yellow, sometimes he's brilliant and white, and I really love to see the sun when it's turning night, when just about 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock for you here in the United States, because in Brazil it's turning dark around 6 o'clock, but it starts to see, we can see the sun shining a little bit among the clouds, and we see the orange, and we see a big pictures, a beautiful pictures in the heaven, and we see just, we stay amazed to see that. It's amazed to see the beauty, a little bit of the beauty of his glory in heaven. And also, the sun is something very interesting. The sun is 109 times bigger than the planet Earth. I was amazed when I was studying about the sun. 109 times bigger than the planet Earth, the sun. Inside the sun fits 1,300,000 planet Earth. Can you believe that? What about that? So the sun is very big. It's the creation of God that we stay amazed to see. A little glimpse of his glory. And we see here also in heaven, there are approximately 10 sextillions of stars in the universe. So we see the glimpse of God's glory in heaven. But we see also the oceans. It's amazing to see the oceans. Just we will not go all the details about the creation, but the creation declares the glory of God. I just want to share something, a little bit, about how big is our God, brethren. Amen. How big is our God? Isaiah chapter 40, verse 11 through 12, the Bible tells us, who hath measured the waters in the hollow of his hand, and meted out heaven with the span, and comprehend the dust of the earth in a measure, and weighed the mountains in scales, and the hills in a balance? How big it is, our God. He's great than we thought. So we see here God also, he ordained the waters of the oceans to stop in the right place. Sometimes I like to watch also the oceans. And God just created the oceans to stop in the right place to not go further. What about that? And also there are places in the oceans uncovered by man. The man did not discover all the oceans. So our God is big, is great. His beauty is declared in all creation. Job chapter 37, verse 5, the Bible tells God thundered marvelously with his voice. Great things goeth him, which we cannot comprehend. We cannot comprehend. Now let's go back. I believe Moses saw all these things. I believe Moses, he was amazed like we are also when we contemplate all the marvels of God, all the creation, the sun, the oceans. By the way, Moses, he saw the Red Sea be just departed and dried out. He saw all those things, and I believe he was amazed. But not only that, but spiritually, he was very amazed also with his relationship with the Lord. Moses was very close to the Lord. We saw the verses that he was speaking to the Lord face to face. Can you believe that, brethren? He was speaking face to face with the Lord, and he was talking to the Lord how a friend talked to another friend. And Moses got to a point that he was thirsty. He was desiring more. Okay, Lord, I saw everything that you created. I saw your powerful way that how you departed the Red Sea. I have been tasting the relationship with you, but I want more, Lord. And we see here something that Moses felt a little bit. In this conversation with the Lord in this chapter, we see Moses talking to the Lord, and the Lord just was telling Moses, okay, we are here talking in a relationship. You want my presence to go with you and the people of Israel? But Moses, I will send you an angel. I will send my presence. You are chosen by me. You have found grace upon my eyes, in my sight. But only my presence will go with you. And we see here Moses very desire to have more. Okay, the Lord is telling me that I found grace in his sight, so look like I can have some more thing from him. You know, we have a saying there in Brazil, okay, if that person, he wants my hand, but he will get my legs as well. We have this type of saying there in Brazil. So we can see here Moses. Okay, the Lord is telling me that his presence will be with me. I have found grace upon his sight. But Lord, I want more. I want something more. I have been seeing your power, your grace, your mercy. We were on journey during the wilderness. I saw you providing for us. I saw you being with us. Your grace, we were with us in the wilderness. Now, Lord, I want something more. I want you to show thy glory. I want to see thy glory. Lord, I want to see thy glory. And we see here the meaning of Moses' heart. I was studying here about this word glory, and it means kabod, which means honorable, rich, abounding, very great, and splendor. It reveals the character of God, the presence of God, and his character. So Moses, he was asking the Lord to see his character, who you are, his deepest glory, the beauty of his glory. That was Moses was asking the Lord. And we see here the answer of Moses' prayer. And he said, my presence my presence will go with thee. And we see there, and he said, my presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest. God did not give what Moses prayed at the beginning. God gave an answer that Moses was not looking for. My presence will go with thee. But Moses was earnestly desiring. And he said, I beseech thee, show me thy glory. Lord, thy presence is important. I have seen you in other ways, but I want to see thy glory. We see here Moses praying and asking the Lord. In Moses, brethren, Moses saw the beauty of his glory. We see here that God showed Moses his glory. See verse 20. And he said, thou canst not see my face, for there shall no man see me and live. And the Lord said, behold, there is a place by me, and thou shalt stand upon a rock. And it shall come to pass, when my glory passed by, that I will put thee in a cliff of the rock, and will cover thee with my hand while I pass by. And I will take away mine hand, and thou shalt see my back parts, but my face shall not see. So we see here, Moses' prayer request was answered. And Moses was able to see God's glory, but just his back parts also. And God made a protection for him to see his glory by the back parts. So, brethren, we will not have time to go all over the details because, like I said, this is the deepest message. But let's think about what did happen to Moses to see God's glory, to see his beauty of his glory. But now let's think about us. What did happen to us? Jesus Christ, the Bible tells us that Jesus Christ, in John chapter 1, verse 14, read if you can, please, John chapter 1, verse 14. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, and the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Brethren, when we think about Jesus Christ, okay, this was a little introduction. Now I would like just to share, you know, really what is in my heart about, just for us to understand a little bit. But when we think about Jesus Christ, when he came down in this earth, he lived in a perfect life. He never sinned before. He never had a bad thought. And we see here in this verse, and the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory. And we beheld his glory, and the glory of the only begotten of the Father. By the way, God showed also his glory through his Son, Jesus Christ, to all of us. Amen. To all of us. So think about this. We will not go to the details how the Lord Jesus Christ lived in this earth, but he was perfect. He was living here, he shared his compassion. He shared his love. And he went to the Calvary for me and I to have the chance, to have the opportunity, to have what Moses had in the past. To contemplate the beauty of his glory. You and I, when we got Jesus Christ into our hearts, when we repented of our sins, when we put our faith in Jesus Christ, the glory of his Son is living inside of us. What about that? The glory of his Son is living inside of us. Brethren, that's something that is very difficult for me sometimes to comprehend. But in other words, we are in a better position than Moses. It's not right. Moses was there begging the Lord and asking the Lord, Lord, please show me thy glory. I want to see thy glory. Show me, Lord, thy glory. And he saw God, I believe, you know, away. He was very far. He was just, you know, in a cliff of rock, his hands upon that brethren. But when I called, when I asked Jesus Christ to become my Savior, when I asked Jesus Christ to save my soul, when I asked Jesus Christ to be my Savior, the glory of God, the Holy Spirit of God is living inside of me and inside of you. And we are just contemplating his glory. Amen. As his son. Jesus look at me and he look at me, he sees his son, his perfect son, no sin and no more. He is the rock. Jesus Christ is the rock. Moses was covered by the rock, and we are covered also by the rock of Jesus Christ. So the beauty of his glory is inside of us. We will not have time to go all the details, brethren, but the perfect beauty of the glory of God, Jesus Christ, is inside of us. So, open your Bible real quickly. 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 18. I'll finish here with this thought, you know. But 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 18. Open there, please. Pastor Adam, can you read, please, this verse? Can you read this verse for me, please? Yes, 3, verse 18. It's very important verse.
But we all, with open face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord, are changed into the same image from glory to glory, even as by the Spirit of the Lord.
Thank you, Pastor. Did you notice it? Brethren, did you notice this verse? But we all, with open face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord, are changed. So we see here something very interesting. The glory of God is living inside of us. No doubt about that. I did not have time to go all through all the other things about the Shekinah, the shining and everything like that. But we see also that happening in Moses' life when he come down from the presence of the Lord. His face is shining, everything like that. And we see here also in this passage of Scripture is telling that the glory of the Lord is from inside out. So we are shining also for God's glory. So brethren, we have to allow the Holy Spirit, the glory of God, the beauty of the God, the beauty of the glory of God to shine through us. And that will make us beauty also, beautiful also. Probably you think, I'm not very beautiful, but, you know, I'm ugly, something like that. But because you have the Spirit of God living inside of you, the beauty of the Lord also will make you. The joy of the Lord will make you also somebody shining for God's glory. So we are in a better position than Moses. That's what I can see here. Better, much better position than Moses. I'll finish with that. With this, I share this testimony in some places, but. I did not share here, but I was preaching in a prison years ago, and I was talking to a guy there. He was very violent. He was not willing to talk to me. He was very mean. He was very aggressive, and I talked to him a little bit, and I just thought, it's better for me to leave. I'm not going to talk to him no more. I will leave. When I was leaving on my way, the Holy Spirit spoke to my heart, come back and talk to him. And I thought, Lord, but he's going to beat me. He's going to spank me. And I was a little afraid, apprehensive. But I went to talk to him anyway. And I went to talk to him. I put my hand on his eye, in his arms, and I asked his name. He told me his name. And I told him, I made this statement, I want you to look at my eyes. Look at my eyes. I told him. He looked at my eyes by that time, and I prayed for him. I told him, you are full of anger, full of bitterness, but your bitterness is not big enough of the love that Jesus Christ has for you. He loves you. He loves you. And I was looking at his eyes and telling that, can I pray for you? And he said, yes. And he was in tears. And I prayed for him. And then I left and I told him, I'll be waiting for you to come to the service. And he bowed his head. He didn't say anything. I went to the service tonight and I was waiting and looking for him. I was all the time looking at the back of the church, at the chapel, and I saw him coming. And he came, he sat down, and I just waved my hand to him and from the first pew, and the preacher came, and he preached, and he came to the altar, and he got saved. He got Jesus Christ in his heart. But I want you to think about this. When I told him, look at my eyes, look at my eyes. It was not John. I believe the Holy Spirit led me to do that. And I understood why. In his eyes, darkness. I saw darkness, bitterness, everything. But when he looked at my eyes, guess what he saw? He saw the presence of God. He saw the beauty of God's glory. So, brethren, every time you go to a place, just take confidence, like that song that we sang. Have confidence. I am the child of God, and I am taking to this place the temple of the Holy Spirit, the presence of the Lord, the joy of the Lord. Because God's glory is inside of you, now you can love your enemies. Now you can love any person. Now you can share love. You can share compassion. You can do everything through Jesus Christ that strengthens you because his glory is inside of you. Amen. Let's pray, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We don't deserve. We are only weak vessel, but I thank you, Lord, because you loved us so much, so much. Your presence is living inside of us. Thy glory, Lord, Moses asked to show thy glory. Oh, Lord, thank you so much because through Jesus Christ we see thy glory and thy glory is living inside of us. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I ask you to bless this time. I pray, Lord, that you bless thy word. May change our lives. May live from this place thinking that we have the glory of God inside of us, changing us all the time. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Pastor Adam.
Please stand with me. Jesus said, let your light so shine before men. He says it's our light, but he doesn't mean it's our light as in the light of us. It's the light of Jesus Christ. It's the glory of God. It's what the world needs to see. I like what Brother John said. What we have is so much better than what Moses got. I'm sure Moses was thankful for being able to be in that place at that time. But we have the Son of God, the express image of the glory of God in us. Man, what a great thought. Brother Dowdy, what are we going to sing this morning? Page 546. If you have a need of some sort, I promise you the Lord is the answer.
If you're here today and you don't know him as your Savior, well, we'd love to introduce you to him today if you give us the opportunity. We'll sing page 546 this morning. The altar's open. If you'd like to make use of the altar this morning, you come as we sing together on the first verse, page 546. You can look right this way. I'd like to get an offering this morning. We'll take the offering up for Brother Alves. So ushers, if you received the offering in just a few minutes ago, why don't you go ahead and get ready, and we'll take up the offering. Everything that comes in this offering, every dime is going to go right to Brother Alves and his family. And we like having them in the States, but they need to get home at some point. And so let's try to take care of them while they're with us. You can be seated for just a couple of minutes. Come on, ushers, as soon as you guys are all ready, let's get this offering. Brother John will be with us again tonight, and he'll be telling us a little bit more about his ministry. And anytime you hear about anything, anytime you hear news from Brazil, I shouldn't say anytime, a lot of the time it's about prison riots and all that goes on in those prisons. And it's a little different there than it is here, and there's a lot there to pray about. And so I'm excited to hear from Brother John tonight about the ministry, what the Lord is doing, the doors that are being opened, and the way God has provided for their training center and all of that in Brazil. So let's take care of the Alves family this morning. You give as the Lord leads, and we'll thank him for that. Let's pray. Father, thank you for, God, thank you for the Alves family. God, thank you for Brother John and, Lord, for his heart for the inmates in Brazil. God, I pray that you would please let us be a blessing and a help to him during this offering. Oh, Lord, would you please continue to take care of and meet his needs? And we'll thank you in Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. All right, let's stand together. We'll be dismissed in prayer. Please come back tonight. Choir practice will be at 4:30, and then, of course, service at 6, prayer meeting at 5:30, and we want you to come back and be a part of all of that. On your way out of the auditorium, we need some help with the sign-up sheet. Those of you that worked the sights and sounds booth all summer long on Thursday nights, thank you for your help. We'll be doing much the same thing at the fair booth, and so maybe you can get involved in that as well. And so if you haven't already signed up, then on your way out, just stop by and see where the open slots are, and maybe you can help us. Not this week, but next week is when all that happens. And if you have any questions at all, talk to Brother Wireman, and he can answer those questions for you and tell you exactly what we need. All right, Lord willing, we'll see you back this afternoon. Brother Dowdy, how about closing us in prayer, please, sir?
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, so much for the message that we heard. Lord, thank you for the Alves family, Lord, and their ministry in Brazil. Pray continue to bless it. Pray be with his family, and Lord, I pray souls would be saved. Lord, we thank you for what you've given to us, the gift of your Son, and Lord, just so many facets to that gift, Lord, that sometimes we don't realize. And thank you for reminding us, Lord, that of the glory that's inside of us. And Lord, may we shine for others. May we show your light to the world. And Lord, we just pray you bless the afternoon. Bring everyone back safely this evening. We pray this all in your name.